Hey there, folks, and welcome back to the Icenia campaign. Last time, we did some infrastructure stuff and built up our navy a little further, and more importantly for this episode, made some plans in northern Gaul, particularly with a claim against Venetia, with the goal of. Nope, not you. Bringing in Venetia's substantial defensive league into a war against us. Just partially to give ourselves a pretty efficient, massive conquest over here. Also, low key to give ourselves an interesting thing to have happen in this series. I'd rather maybe make a slightly less strategically perfect decision and have more interesting content in the YouTube series, just because this is, of course, all being recorded and commentated and then being rendered and put on YouTube. I am trying to think about what will be interesting for the audience. Yes, I could probably be a little bit sneakier and one by one take out these nations the way I did near the start of this series back when I had a lot less resources. But now that I have the capacity to fight a huge war, you know what? That's kind of fun. I think I'd rather do that than just take it easy every chance that I can. So that's kind of the situation there. And then a similar situation up in the Meridian planned war. So, also something I just noticed that I noticed, or I didn't just notice it. I noticed it in the I was rewatching one of my previous episodes, and I noticed Manapia up here, and I thought, wait a minute, isn't that a Belgic nation? No, there's a Belgic nation called Menapia, so that's a little confusing. Not really sure what the deal is with that. Just a similar name, I suppose. Who knows? Let's resume. Also, this is once again that decision. We're going to turn that off. And here we go. So we're just waiting for these claims and trying to. What's the issue here? Bad research ratio again. It's just okay. Let's take a chance here to actually look at this. Also, I should have said this at the start of the episode, but I'll mention it now. I actually just got back from a 2 mile walk. So maybe for some of you that doesn't sound like much, but for me that was 2 more miles than I've ever walked in quite some time. So I'm trying to get into a better exercise kind of pattern for my personal life. So if I'm a little tired or I sound sore, which I don't know how my voice would communicate that, but I suppose it might. If that's the case, then you know why. Anyways, so reducing 303 each year from 463 integrated culture pops. What's the issue? I think it's mostly because of noble happiness, which we can, of course, zoom in very jankily to investigate. Nobles in Londinium are basically perfectly happy, so that's not the issue. What about in Durwurnum? Things are a little bit worse over here, but I don't think there's much we can really do about it down here. Yeah, we can of course build more academies as soon as we have the slots for it. I'd rather build up a level 3 port first. Where else am I going to find nobles? Maybe Alconum? Yeah, there's a couple nobles over here. Are these all Akeni nobles? Yeah, they're all Druidic Akeni nobles, so that's all fine. I could build up a building in Alconum here, which I. Although, actually, I shouldn't spend any money because I did recently spend a lot of money on my missions. And I am still trapped in the Matter of Caledonia only thing. I said last episode I'd look at the wiki. I then forgot to look at the wiki, so apologies for that. This episode will be another missionless episode. And because I record these videos in a bulk sense, so here's the city thing. And then I sort of schedule them to be released twice a week, Wednesdays and Sundays at noon, as you've probably noticed. I often don't read comments on my more recent videos until weeks away when they are published. So possibly after the point, or around the point this video comes out, there will have been comments made several weeks before this point in real. I'm not making any sense. I'm not going to be able to read comments left by people saying what the deal is with the missions. Sorry about that. It's just because of the way that the videos are scheduled and release in a delayed sense. Okay, I'm going to stop trying to explain hard concepts while I'm still on tired brain mode. I do have some coffee here, so we're going to go ahead and just sip some coffee here. It's good. All right. The coming of the city of Manawia. Our extension of new privileges and investments into the local infrastructure have seen Manawia grow from relative humility into a true Akeni city. While it still has some way to go before it can rival the great cities of our age, the past 2 years have ushered in a new era of growth and urbanization in this territory. Manawia, I think, switches from fish, I think, to producing cloth, so that's a better resource for sure. And here it is, located here on the island. Very exciting. So now that it's a city, we can immediately. Well, of course, now I'm trying to save money, so should I do anything too crazy here? Yeah, so mercenary. Sorry, I'm clicking on the mercenary to remind myself what the basic cost is going to be for a mercenary stack of about this size. I may need to use mercenaries in my upcoming wars. We will see what the situation is, given we don't really have our entire manpower reserve refilled right now. Actually, if I did know I was going to do these wars, I should have probably planned. Also, this is glitching out a little bit over here. I should have actually done that technology that gave me 5,000 manpower. That could have been quite useful here, but it is what it is. I didn't think about doing these wars when I made those tech decisions, and I did check before this episode started, and I'm not close to getting another tech anytime soon. It's okay. Not a big deal. But I think since I'm about to be in a situation where I may have enemy navies, not that many navies, but potential enemy, like just troops that exist because I'd be in a war, I think it would be worth building a fort here in Manawia. This will also, well, I guess it does affect the manpower a bit, but it also gives civ level, so it does have its advantages. I think I will build a fort. Ah, it's quite expensive though. The thing is, my income is so good, I'm not going to be in trouble of going into the red with my levies raised. That's certainly not going to be an issue. I don't have any legions set up yet. Of course, I don't have the law that allows for legions from the capital region, so let's go for it. I think it's fine to invest like this. And I definitely want to build a fort here. This is a very difficult place to recapture if an enemy army, especially, say, one of the enemies. I mean, really, what I should say, the danger with fighting multiple targets at once now isn't their levies, it's them each having a treasury with which they can hire mercenaries. And there are a lot of mercenary companies hanging out around this area. The ones up in Britain, I think, are a little further away for them to access, because if they do hire them, they have to bring them to friendly territory to turn off their black flag. But, or I think maybe just going into, I think unsettled territory doesn't remove the black flag status. I think a few episodes ago I was wondering about that. I don't remember what the answer was, but either way, having Manawia be fortified is going to be handy. It will be done after the war can start, but I don't know if I'll start it right when I can start it. We'll have to see. And making sure I do have my thing here. Yeah, this is fine. All right. This is ticking up. 79 per month is actually pretty nice. Or 78, 79. Don't know exactly, but it is pretty good. So, Rhododendron. All right, that's fine. I'll sell that to you. Oh, this is from Manawia's cloth. They're producing two cloth. I don't know why they're producing. This is another instance where the fact it's producing a second thing of cloth is just kind of baffling. It's not because of the slave amount, definitely not. Who knows, honestly. Looks like Rhodonia is fighting Venetia. Now, Rhodonia, they're not in the defensive alliance, but actually their revolt is in the defensive alliance, so I'm presuming you're at war with Rhodonia. So potentially the troops from the revolt faction will be distracted in the war against Venetia. So we gotta hope for some good luck there. Yeah. And then if we take a look at our actual military, the other thing I could do is I could raise all of my levies. That would give me, let's see here, about 39 individual units. I don't remember offhand how many thousands of people that is, but it's gonna be something like around 19, 20,000 actual men, which could definitely take on even the combined levies of these nations, because if they each have 2,000 men, again, split between four levies because they're tribes. So let's see. That'd be 2,000, 4,000, 8,000, 10,000, 12,000, maybe. I mean, 14. So 14,000 at most. But I don't think the Rhodonian Revolt has all their soldiers up because they've been fighting this war. Has anyone else been fighting war? Actually, Venetia is fighting a war against Turonia. So this is interesting. Actually, I didn't even notice this before. This may have started during this episode, but there's actually already a war going on with Turonia that some of the members of the Defensive League seem to be involved in. Not you, but maybe. Yeah, okay, so Venetia's actual ally Nemnetia is involved too. So Venetia and Nemnetia may not have all their soldiers, or may not have their soldiers located in Venetian territory, or sort of around here. They may be distracted, which means this is actually going to be a pretty good opportunity for the war. There's probably not a good justification in delaying the war, which means it's time to get my actual soldiers ready. So let's go ahead and get our navy over to Manawia, which I'll explain why I'm doing that in a moment. And I'm also going to... Oh yeah, so I don't need to raise up the rest of my guys. Bellicianus Welbus died of dysentery at the age of 90. Oh my gosh, this guy's one of my oldest characters who's died at an old age. He was the head of the Welbii family and a rival to the King of Britannia. Okay, so that's, you know, always sad to see an old character die, but I suppose that does potentially improve our situation here. Who's the new head of the family? Looks like Cinerix. You are not employed in the government. You're pretty loyal, so that's actually a nice change, but your power base will probably increase once the head of the family modifier maybe takes more effect. I don't know if that hasn't taken effect yet, but I don't expect to see this kind of loyalty from a head of a family for very long. It is what it is. All right, so what we're going to do is send our ships over, pick up the Caledonian troops from Manawia, and then as they're coming down, drop them off down here, and then pick up our Pratonic troops from Ulconum, and then we'll raise the what's this region called? The Armorican troops from down here. So that's the plan. Let's also go ahead and get our naval maintenance going. This is probably overkill, but I think I'd rather spend more money just for extra safety because I have the money. And if somehow I lost a bunch of ships in some sort of bizarre naval catastrophe, that would be very expensive to fix. So I'd rather spend some money now as insurance against any future strangeness. All right, so the Venetian claim should be done pretty soon. And I could have probably started this process a little earlier to get everything in position in time, but that's fine. It's okay that it's not ready right when the claim is ready. Gives us a bit more time to recover more manpower, up to 10,000 in reserve. Sack of the Glanis Shrine, the great shrine to Avenio, the great shrine in Avenio, which is in Arwernia, dedicated to Glanis, has been sacked by the forces of Arwernia. Okay, that's a little... okay, so it's actually a Vicontian revolt territory that Arwernia has occupied. Okay, my mistake. Our priests assure us that this can only bring bad fortune upon their people. Well, I guess I'd rather get opinion than lose opinion with some random Gallic nation, so I'm not going to worry too much about that. I try not to recommend changes to the game that make it like more punishing for the player, because I think there's already a lot of mechanical obtuseness in this game, but I do think that event in particular should have some sort of malice to omen effect or something like that to represent taking sides against your religion. Maybe just a very minor one, like a -1% omen effect for a few months, or like something very, very minuscule, just to represent like you're taking a stance that's kind of contrary to your religion, or maybe like reduced happiness from people in your religion. I don't know. Anyways, let's go ahead and raise the levies. Raise the Caledonian levies in Caledonia. Let's actually make sure we do this from the levy map mode so this goes correctly. There they are. All right, on the boats you go. And now we're going to go down. And I think we can actually, with this navy, also pick up the... let's actually find out together if we can pick up the levy from Ulconum. Also, we should definitely get our levy payment happening here as well. So let's test out now if the navy can carry multiple separate armies. I don't think it can, but I may be completely wrong about this. Not sure. We'll discover this. That was kind of strange. All right. Yeah, it looks like Nemnetia is getting completely obliterated, which means actually Venetia and Nemnetia probably don't even have armies remaining. Now, this war may be complicated because this may compete with my ability to take over a Nemnetian land. So what I might do... Well, actually, hold on. If Terronia wins the war, and they actually... Let's see here. They win the war against Nemnetia, and they take over Nemnetia's territory, If I had to fight Turonia separately, their only ally is Carnutia, who's, so again, this is going to be another, 4,000 men in this block, and they're in a defensive alliance with Carnutia also, so this is not a complicated separate faction I'd have to deal with here. So that's fine. All right. This is going good. Should I build something in Olconum, actually, since I am spending money? It might be worth building an academy in Olconum for the noble happiness. I know I've really fixated on making my nobles happy, but just technology in this game is so powerful, and it really puts you in that vibe of like actual ancient history where people were very focused on the happiness of the nobility for sort of similar reasons. But I think, any given territory. Yeah, so that's not, that's settlement level and not, what am I trying to say, provincial level, so. Yeah, let's go for it. We already have a level 3 port there, and I don't want to build up more levels of forts. Or actually, hold on, I should have raised my levy by now. Whoops, alright. There we go. They're actually almost at full morale anyways, so everything is fine. Can we embark you? Okay, we can only embark one group at a time. Oh no, we can embark both at a time. Alright, that's handy. I mean, it's because the ships have the capacity for it. I always forget how capacity is calculated. Let's see. I don't think I'm gonna find it on the screen anywhere. This is something I need to check the wiki for, honestly. Anyways. Well, actually, hold on. Is there a. I don't think there is there? There's no, like, help button in this game. No. I'm thinking of Crusader Kings 3 again. Okay, that's fine. Let's head on down to Agritore and also raise the levy in Agritore. Is going to be the first time our entire army, all of our levies are all raised and following each other together in a group. Ooh, okay, this is another. So, again, kind of like a few episodes ago, even though I normally prefer stability, we're actually above 50 stability, which means our growth is not going to be very, because it's decaying right now, except for the ruler zeal propping it up. So extra stability right now is actually not very efficient. However, 227 gold, or almost 228 gold, is quite nice, given especially that we are currently happen to be a little low on our treasury. And with all of our armies and navy at full morale, we are at about 12 per, so a little less bountiful per month than we've been at before. Nice little safety net for this war. This should be a pretty unproblematic war, unless every single nation we fight hires a 6,000 stack mercenary group. I'm looking at this merc group in particular, but they are actually still recovering from. I think they were hired by. They were hired by the nation who lived here, Sismia. That's right. Okay. Now, these forces cannot be combined because they're all led by different governors. Yeah. That's fine. We're going to go ahead and tell the other forces to follow the force led by Donis. So we're going to tell Donis that he can have. I haven't done actual army micromanagement in so long. This is kind of exciting. Attachment is allowed. The first levy of Britannia led by Donis. Very exciting. Let's give you the correct. Looks like envelopment is still going to be the best thing here. Yeah, they're going to get messed up by shock action, but that should be okay. All right. And the first levy of Armorica, you're going to follow the first levy of Donis around, or first levy of Donis, first levy of Britannia around. Attach the unit, and you're going to do, looks like, since it's the same, let's set you to shock action just for a little bit of coverage. And the first levy of Caledonia, same business. And shock action is still fine for you. All right. Oh, let's also actually go through and make sure this is. I don't know if this matters at all, but let's just double do. Let's do this just to be safe. Heavy infantry in the back, chariots. I don't usually do this, but I think because we're going to be dealing with potentially a larger war, I would rather do this correctly. And, save our manpower as we are only around 4,000. And now for the big army, this is the fun part. All right, supply trains on all line. No, I'm just kidding. Donis is not that stupid with Marshall, though. He is pretty bad. Let's not have our supply train army here. Light infantry in the front, heavy infantry in the back, and chariots in the side. The classic Britannian style thing. 19,000 men, here we go. Well, actually, first we're going to move to Wargium, and then we will go once we move to Wargium, so then we can move to Sulis immediately. Alright. And the other thing I'm going to do is I think I'm going to split my navy into several sections, which means I need to get a couple other admirals. So let's split in half. Yeah, 2010 is going to be the right amount. So the first navy, and then this is going to... I'm going to have to manually recall it. So we have the second navy. Yeah, alright, so we're going to give you a commander. Don't need to worry about having it be someone from a family, because I'm just looking for a kind of a temporary command arrangement here. So this guy's pretty qualified, as are you. Maybe someone a bit younger who could be a more permanent... Yeah, because you also have 8 Marshall. Loyalty's really good. You're a minor character. Corruption's pretty bad, though. Why is that? What's your issue? Yeah, you're corrupt. So that's not going to help your corruption. So that's actually just from that. So you're otherwise okay. All right. The second navy has itself a leader. Maius Urcus, you're going to be the naval commander. Very good. Your morale not being at full is not a huge deal. I'm not anticipating a massive naval fight immediately. Now what we're going to do is we're going to have... the much better, actually, Maius is technically a better naval commander than Boyrix, unless there's some other modifier Boyrix has from being a naval commander so long. Doesn't look like it, that's fine. Yeah. Anyways, but I do trust Boyrix. I mean, that's not really a real thing, but it's just something in my head. So our southernmost foe is going to end up being Santonia, who is not in a war with anybody. And Pictonia is also going to be involved, so down here. So what we're going to do, we're going to send the first navy, which is currently has slightly better morale, to go control this tile here. These are all called the same thing, the Mare Cantabrum. And then the second navy is going to control up here, the northern tile, which also controls the mouth of this river, just to protect this area from enemy navies. Again, I'm not scared of them having any chance of defeating me on the sea. I have a much, much bigger navy than any of them put together. But I just want to use my navy since I've invested so much into it, and this is the chance to do it when you have a big coastline of belligerents. Alright, so we are here. We are still building up our morale, so let's give it one more month, end of October perhaps, then we'll move on in. Should be fine. I think this force is recovering to 8,000, so I'll keep an eye on that, but I think we should be okay. And this force not being at full morale, not a huge deal. We're going to go for it now. All right. Down to speed to finally another big war for this series. I know. Oh my gosh, Arunia. I didn't even notice you. Oh my gosh. Arunia is going... Okay, this is actually kind of interesting. If we actually take all this territory, we're going to immediately be bordering a pretty powerful nation down here, Arunia. They usually do pretty well because they have unique Arunia ideas from real history, but... or based upon real history. Anyways, we'll deal with that in a moment. First things first, it's time for war. So we're going to declare war on Venetia for the purpose of, quote-unquote, reunifying the province of Ossissimia. But of course, we have some broader ambitions. Let's go. Take Ossissimia. Brigantia will join. Okay, well, that's good to hear. I was worried until they told me, so... Looks good. Let's do it. The Gallic local power of Venetia, Santonia, Pictonia, Namnetia, and Curio Solita have all rallied together to defend this war. Here we go. Alright, so Donis is going to lead the way into Sulis and immediately take over that territory. I guess I've got to wait for my navies to be in position. I'm not scared. I don't think I need to be. Alright, so they already have a couple navies hanging out in the river. This is going to block them. Ooh. There's actually a pirate navy hanging out here. This is interesting. I guess the pirates could be hired. I hadn't thought about this, but yeah, there are mercenary navies. So we'll keep an eye on that too, but it should be okay. What do you want? You need leather from Durotriga. That's fine. In we go. Now, what I could have done is probably split my force, but I want to immediately. So let me actually explain why I'm not going to split my force here, because even though I could, I have such a huge force. What I'm thinking is once I take. Well, Having said that, I really could probably split my force. Could send. I think what I'd rather do though, I'd rather secure Sulis with my entire force while the enemies kind of get organized. Because I don't want to have to be chasing around tons of little forces sort of going past me. So I'd rather just overwhelm Sulis here. I'm not going to do an assault because that's pretty costly. I'll just overwhelm it with a gigantic siege. Yes, there is some attrition. Well, actually, hold on. There's quite some attrition problems. 5% attrition is pretty nasty, so maybe I won't actually stay here entirely. Who are you? Oh. No, I'd rather sell to someone who's not on my island. Okay, change of plans. We are going to split our force slightly. We're going to keep. No, actually, no. We're going to keep our whole force together. I'm just going to eat the attrition. The other armies that I have. Well, I didn't really think about the attrition issues here. Yeah, 5% attrition isn't justifiable. Yeah, with my manpower. All right, well, What we're gonna do is we're gonna split off the smaller armies, and we're gonna have them work together as a unit. And we're gonna, yeah, so this, I feel a bit better about this. So I'm gonna keep 4,000 stack, bring you back over to Agritore, and then send you down. Stone. All right, here we go, stone. Oh my gosh, all right. And we'll send the second navy over to pick them up, and then we'll bring them down around the zone of control of Sulis to go into the southern area. The thing is, I guess I could have probably done that the other way, where the larger army goes into the more dangerous southern area, but I think this should still be okay. I'm just a little bit worried about them hiring mercenaries up here and not having a force big enough to fight potentially two mercenary forces up here. Anyways, oh, you as well. Oh my gosh. There we go. Next, what I could do is actually come over to Dariorigam. Yeah, let's do it like that. Okay, so we're gonna keep our forces pretty close together and just have them come up here because I can't reach here except for conquering that. So we'll get this under control and then we'll make our way down on foot. So that's the plan. You as well. Okay. And this is the year we have to do another omen, so we got to keep an eye on that. Let's have the levy of Armorica actually lead the way. Actually, 3 versus 4. Actually, okay, we'll have Winoba lead the way technically. Set you to attachment allowed, and you're gonna follow Winoma. All right. Looking good so far. Keeping an eye on everything. Okay, it does look like Namnedia is beating back the Turonian invasion, so that's good to see, for me at least, because it means that I can take this land myself. But that means their army is around this area, so we have to be a little careful up there. There's Ilkhonum's Academy being constructed, very good. Our manpower is so far still looking pretty good. If I stayed with my whole force there, we would have spent, let's see here, 5% of, it looks like my game is lagging once again, sorry about that. Well, while it's lagging, I'll just talk. We would have spent something like 5% of about 19,000. What is that exactly? Do some quick math here. Let's see. There we go. That took a moment to load there. A little alarming. Let's see. 19,000. Okay, I don't know how to do math, but it would have been a lot of people. We would have used a lot of our manpower to facilitate that siege when we don't need to do it like that. All right, capture the slave, that's fine. Now that that's under control, we're going to move on into Dureti. All right. Looking good. Probably could have got away with not paying my. Oh, hello. What's this? Oh my gosh, my game is really struggling right now. I've never seen it have this much trouble. I've actually recently, because my CPU is getting pretty old, I think that's the reason my computer's been having this trouble. I've actually bought a new CPU and it is being shipped to me, but I do have to wait for that. What is the issue here? Oh yeah, we definitely. Are we really not going to win this fight? We have 500 more men than they do. Oh, they have a really good commander. Okay. All right, let's not do that actually, and let's just stay here next to our main army. So probably should have just switched it around. Yeah, because these guys have military access through Curio Solita. Wait, hold on. I also have access. Oh, they're in the war. Pfft, okay. Yeah, that makes sense. All right, so that clears that up. All right, so we're gonna go ahead. Hold on. Let's go here, and then we're gonna move our main army over to siege down Curio Solitum. That makes more sense, I think. Yeah, my ships being here is mostly just to stop them using their navies to transport troops up around my soldiers. I'm trying to control the passageway along this coastline. It's kind of the idea, at least. All right, so the Britannic levy will now head over here. They'll have to go like that, but that's fine. I'd rather have them be closer to the army, if that makes sense. It does look like they're gathering their forces in Matrianica. Matrianica. All right, we got the thing on Meridia now. That's good. But they're going to be able to retake this, but that's fine. It's just going to distract them. I guess I could have. No, that's fine. We're keeping them moving around. As soon as we have this fort under control, our movement is going to be a lot smoother around here. Hold on. Forgot to restart my timer. Believe it or not, I do use a timer for this series. There we go. Heated debates in the court are not uncommon, especially where so many prominent members of society are involved. Lately, a wave of xenophobia has swept across Britannia, resulting in foreign values being regarded with great distrust. All in attendance today's debate agreed, however, that, oh God, Demno Velianus Calatus crossed the line today when he accused King Donis of indulging in barbaric Moisi practices. Alright, who are you? You're just some old guy in the Calatii family. Well, we'll go ahead and get a rivalry for some popularity. That's fine. Not a huge deal. Okay, now we've got some actual situations happening down here. So this is going to be at current. Let's see here. Is so these are all the levies. So my naval action did slow them all down. I guess I could have posted my ships over here over the Liger River to slow them down even more. Didn't really think about that, but that may become relevant in the future of this war. So we're going to be facing a 10,500 force, which does mean we probably need to recombine our army and abandon possibly this siege. If this. No, we're not going to get lucky on a 0% win because there's no way for us to win that siege. So we're going to have to cut our losses and come back over here. That's unfortunate, but it is what it is. Yeah, should be fine. We should be able to make it with plenty of time to spare. No big deal. Or maybe it is a big deal. Hold on. Okay, actually, it is going to be a big deal. What's the timeline here? 15th of May. You're going to get there on the 4th of May. Shoot. Okay, I got outplayed by the AI. My maneuvering skills are really rusty. Clearly, I didn't think this through very well. I say we chance it. And maybe even let this army take a beating so that this army can come back in. That may not be the wisest decision, because yes, I'm going to lose the siege progress that I made. But the thing is, I don't need to win this war fast. I just need to win this war with efficiency in terms of manpower. I think I'd rather spend more time and more money paying for the troops and lose less manpower. Now we're down to seven. How is our manpower being like affected here? What is the deal? I guess it's because our levies are actually raised that the manpower cap is way reduced. I think that's one effect that your levies being raised actually. Yeah, local manpower is way reduced. So this is the amount when the full levy of the whole nation is raised. Okay. Okay, this actually doesn't save us. That's on the 15th. How about this? 17th. Okay, this is an issue. We're not going to be able to get away. And since we can't get away, I think I'd rather. Well, actually, hold on. I say that. Seven. So now it's the 17th. 15th. Sixteenth. Okay, hold on. Yeah, it's not gonna be. It's actually gonna. I could have stayed. I just lost one thing of siege timer, so that's fine. So it's actually not gonna be very long to get from Gior-Loria to Sulis. And also, as usual, their AI is getting kind of wild. And they're all shifting around. So 15th of May, they're gonna arrive on the 16th. We're actually gonna be completely okay. We're gonna have one day of this army being smacked about, but then our huge reinforcement army will arrive, so it's actually going to be okay. Okay, they actually stopped. All right, so pretty tense moment there, but we managed to scare them away with our massive reinforcement army coming in. All right, I think we're just going to keep our forces together in Sulis. Let's not be greedy. Let's just very carefully. Oh, hold on, wait. Let's just watch this carefully. Let's see if we can trap them on the southern side of the river. That would be pretty huge. That's the entire enemy coalition army all put together. So if they're going to cross over, which they might be doing, we're going to trap them. That's going to be enormously helpful. Okay, or trapping some of them will be helpful. I think the AI may even just get scared seeing my navy there and start to do some strange things in terms of movement, so should be okay. Okay, that's a large number of forces. It looks like they've got at least up on the top of that list there. I can't scroll through this list, of course, but they've got two mercenary forces with about how many is that? Let's see here. 12 cohorts, 9 cohorts, so what is that? 6,000. I don't know the exact number, but several thousand mercenaries. So now we actually have a genuine contest here, especially if they reach me before I retake this, or if I take this. And knowing my luck with siege timers, I'm not confident I'm going to be able to finish the siege before they arrive. So we may need to use some of our money to get those mercs after all. Let's wait a little longer. If I win the 7%, that's going to really, really affect everything. Can I win a 7% for the first time, I think, in the whole series? Yeah, of course not. All right, so now we're gonna have to do something a little drastic here. If I want to stay here, and here's the thing, even though I'd be attacking into the plains, I'd be attacking with a force that is about 1,000 more, and probably, let's see here. No, they're gonna have, yeah, because of all these. Oh my god, 15 Marshall? 14. Look at these mercenary leaders. Oh my lord. Okay. That's pretty scary. I've never seen a character with Marshall like that. Oh my gosh, just 10 Marshall, 8 Marshall. Okay, those mercenary leaders are crazy strong. Okay, this is a little intense all of a sudden. The issue is, if I hire mercs now, they're not going to be ready to actually like fight. Their morale will be at zero. I mean, Brigantia is on their way, but I don't think they have any ships, so it's not going to help that much. Well, before making any decisions, here's that Collatii guy who's now, of course, disloyal, as I suspected he would be. Or no, this is a different character in our mind. Yeah, this is the rival of the ruler. That's fine. We're not at the threshold, so I'm not going to worry about it. What do I do here? I think if they only had like, five martial characters, I'd be able to beat this army, but with martial characters like those, I'm definitely not so confident, even with my numerical advantage. And these mercs wouldn't be ready in time. So I think what I need to do is end the episode here. Sorry to leave you on a cliffhanger, but I need to reevaluate my new strategic direction here. But Thank you so much for watching this action-packed beginning episode of this new arc of the war side of this series. We are now truly, indeed, back where we were in the past with these maneuvering situations. But thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time for the thrilling continuance of this situation. See you all next time.